today's video, we move on to network models. I'll motivate why we need network models and look at a very interesting random network model which was proposed by Erdos and Renyi.
Right.
The moment you have a network, you want to try and understand what are the properties of a network. Right? We always want to classify things in science and engineering so that we can bin them into observations that we can study collectively. So we want to create models that mimic real world networks based on a theory. Maybe I make some assumptions, this is how people connect to one another, and I use those assumptions to build a network and then see if it matches my social network. Then I can make some comment that, oh, maybe this is how people networks get formed in real life as well.
Right.
And essentially, as we always mentioned, the highest goal would be to actually glean out some design principles, right? Or what is the generative model for a particular type of real network, be it a gene regulatory network or a protein interaction network or a metabolic network. What is the underlying principle for generating that kind of a network? And we always like to bin our observations into some canonicals, right? Oh, this is one class of networks, this is another class of networks, this is another class of networks. So my network looks like this class A, the other network looks like this class B network, and so on, right? And this will obviously help us to improve our understanding of real world networks and also the ability to analyze, simulate them or predict how they perform in different scenarios. For example, what happens when you start removing nodes from different kinds of networks? How does a perturbation cascade? How does a perturbation, does it affect the network? Does it destroy the network? Or does it have no effect on the network? And so on. So the first type of a network is a random network, or what we call an Erdos Renyi random network. These were the two scientists who came up with this network way back in 1960. Right. So let's say I want to create a network with n nodes and e edges. How do you create a network? What would be a random network, right? What do you think is a random network? What would random mean in the first place? There is no pattern, right? There is no specific structure in the network, right? If you have no structure, how should it be? How should the network be connected? The connections are formed randomly and no node is special, right? Which means I have E edges, I have to literally take those E edges and throw them such that they land randomly amongst the possible n choose 2 edges. I have n choose 2 possible edges, out of which I want to fill E edges at random, which means I could basically just take a probability P equals E by NC2 and with that probability connect every pair of nodes, right? So now I will just keep picking node pairs at random from here and connect them with probability which is basically nothing but E by N choose 2. So what would this give you? It will give you a network where no node is sort of special. Right. What would the degree distribution look like? What is the degree distribution again? It is a count of the number of neighbors for every node, right? So degree distribution will essentially look like this. So P of k or n of k, number of nodes with degree k versus k. So a common mistake is to assume that the degree distribution might come out as uniform, right? Because we are connecting every node with probability P. But if you look at it closely, you will see that it is like tossing a coin. You have a probability P of success, and what are you counting? The number of successes, right? So, the number of successes for a given node, right? So, what is that going to look like? A binomial, or it will start looking like a Poisson in, yeah, look somewhat like this. Right. So, you can compare this with binomial as well, right. So, this is the limiting case of a binomial distribution. So, you will see that this is how it looks, but you know the spread is not too much, right. This is not a normal curve where you have like a big spread, right. So, the spread is not too much, you will find that no node has much higher degree than another node. Erdos Renyi random networks. So, you start with n nodes and connect each pair of nodes to the probability p, which will give you approximately p n choose to randomly placed edges. So, the node degree follows a Poisson distribution. Most nodes have approximately the same number of links. You also have to figure out what does the characteristic path length look like, and maybe what does the average degree look like, what is the diameter of the network, and so on. So, characteristic path length happens to be proportional to log n, which is quite small. Yeah. So, there are mathematical derivations for all of these. I am going to skip all of them in this class, but there are mathematical derivations for all of these. And Ck versus k is actually independent of k. Right, the clustering coefficient for a node with degree k does not depend on k. So, it is essentially like flatlining. But it turned out that this does not really represent many real networks. Of course, the idea here was not to represent real networks, but the idea was to get a sort of a base model to compare real networks with. But then people started wondering, how do I make network models that are more realistic, that look like real networks? In today's video, I hope you had a good introduction to random networks, but real networks are seldom random. Next video, we will look at some important canonical models of real world networks, namely the small world networks and power law networks.